Okay, 亲爱的弟兄姐妹平安。
Peace, brother and sisters.
中国有一个非常聪明的传道人叫做边云波。
There's a very famous Chinese preacher in China, brother Bian Yunbo.
And 几十年前他就有一个很经典的一首诗。
Many years ago, he had a very classic poem.
叫做《献给无名的传道者》。
It's for the nameless preachers.
Yeah. 所以你们可以去网上看《无名的传道者》。
You can search it online.、
然后呢，这首诗呢，它这个有一个终极的点。
And in this poem, there is a very important point.
The central core. 就是当人见到越发的黑暗。
When、
艰难的时候
，humanity goes into a very dark and difficult time.
黎明的曙光就遥遥可见。
The light of dawn can be seen from afar.
所以我们现在真的知道，人世间已经到一个非常黑暗的时候。
And we now know that humanity has gone into a very dark time.
你们在美国呢，就是每天都快快乐乐的，你们看见的。世界的黑暗还算小。
We are in America, and every day we are pretty happy, and we don't really see much of the darkness of the world.
Yeah, you see some, but it's a very, very poor, small portion of it. 好，但这个世界整体来说，现在是一个非常黑暗的关键的时候。
But the entire humanity right now is in a very dark place, overall.
所以我们今天这个信息叫做“等待黎明”。
So the title of this message today is Awaiting the Dawn.
不是唱歌的那个黎明。
Not the singer Leon in Hong Kong.
所以彼得在彼得后书三章十三节。
Second Peter chapter 3:13.
他谈到世界的末了。
He talks about the end times.
他就说了一句说话，但我们照他的应许盼望新天新地，有义居住在其中。
He said, but in keeping with his promise, we are looking forward to a new heaven and a new earth where righteousness dwells. And you can see this is how the hope of Christians are.
无论世界是多么的黑暗,
no matter how dark the world is,
我们盼望着一个新天新地,
we have hope looking towards a new heaven and a new earth.
是一个公义,
it's a righteous,
充满了神荣耀的世界。
A world full of God's glory.
所以现在世界的黑暗是暂时的。
So right now the darkness in the world is temporal.
虽然很黑暗。
Even though it's very dark.
但是黎明的曙光。
But the light of dawn.
是遥遥可见。
Can be seen from far away.
好，所以在启示录第二十二章最后哪一章。
Revelation 22.
他就告诉天使告诉约翰说，这些事情。是可信的，是真实的。
The angel told John, "These things are truthful."
我们知道启示录里面所讲的一切的预言必定会实现。
We know that all prophecies in Revelation will come to pass.
并且遵守写书上预言的有福了。
And those who keep to these words in the book will be blessed.
所以弟兄姐妹，如果你不懂得启示录，你怎么去遵守书上的预言呢
？So brothers and sisters, if you don't understand the book of Revelation, how can you keep it?
就是如果你能够明白神的心意。
If you can understand the heart of God,
在启示录书上的心意
what is His will in this book of Revelation?
你就能够遵守
then you can keep
按着他的心意而行
and walk in accordance with His word.
好，所以启示录呢有不同的版本啊。四个不同的版本。
There are many versions to in understanding the book of Revelation.
有四大类的行的神学家，所以四类的版本都是。基督教所承认的。
There are four views that are recognized by Christianity.
我们是男孩子教会。
We are man-child church.
所以我们的那个版本呢
？Therefore, our version.
你要很清楚明白。
You need to understand clearly.
就好像你去读大学读数学，你会知道有 whole curriculum， 就是你知道你的课程是怎么样，是吧
？Like if you go study college, you need to understand your curriculum and the whole course of study.
你不会进到大学就是读单，其实不知道前面还有多少要读的，你要读多少才能够拿到什么学位，你不会的，是吧
？You won't just go into college and study without knowing what you're studying for and where you're going.
所以如果你看启示录
If you look at Book of Revelation,
我上次讲的跟今天讲的，如果你真的听得明白。
From what I said last week and today, if you really understand,
上次从十二章讲到二十二。
Last time from the chapter 12 to chapter 22.
今天是二十二倒转头讲到十二。
Now from 22 backwards to the chapter 12.
我会加插一点的内容。
I will add more details.
这两篇信息，如果你回家，就是多听一两篇，如果听不明白。
If you don't understand, go home and listen to the recording more.
你就好像一个人。走在一条男孩子教会的路线。
You're like a person who's walking in this man-child path.
你进到一个大学的里面，你知道你所有的课程。
You enter into college, you know what curriculum, what courses you're taking.
就好像有人说，我是空手道的。
Like someone says, I do karate.
人家就问你，空手道几多段？你就说我不知道。
And someone asks you, "Oh, which level of karate are you at?" You say, "Oh, I don't know."
你是红带啊，那是蓝带或者什么黑带啊，或者什么石黑带、七段黑带，就是你要知道你自己走在哪个地方。
Are you red belt, blue belt, or black belt, or you need to know where you are?
啊，这两篇信息很重要。
These two messages are very important.
如果你们不太懂圣经的人，很难听得懂。
The people who don't really know Bible well will find it hard to understand.
所以回去好好读启示录啊。
So please go back and really study the book of Revelation.
然后呢，再听这两篇的信息。
Then when you listen, you will understand.
Okay. 现在开始了，我需要你们的 attention span 是一个四十分钟的 attention span.
I need you guys to have an attention span of 40 minutes.
如果你呢？没有四十分钟的 attention span， 你就是普通人，就等于是傻傻的人。
If you don't even have an attention span of 40 minutes, you're just a regular person that is not very smart.
Yeah, 傻傻的人。Kind of 我讲的这个是基督教里面，如果有些信息是重要，你就不可以用普通人啊，我只有十五分钟。
I'm talking about in Christianity. If there are important messages, you can't just use a common mindset that, oh, my attention span is only 15 minutes.
如果你打游戏机，有一个打一个小时，你都可以很专注，很 focus.
If you play video games and can focus for 1 hour,
是吧？ Don't tell me you cannot focus for 1 hour in video games. Otherwise, you really have some problem. 所以我要你用这个打油漆机的精神来听以下的四十分钟。
I need your attention of playing video games to listen to the coming 40 minutes.
好，一开始二十二章开始就说，遵守这树上预言的有福了。
Revelation 22, those who keep the word of this book of Revelation will be blessed.
Okay, we got it. 所以我们现在要看。要遵守什么
？So let's look at what are the things we have to keep.
神的心意是什么
？What is the heart of God?
二十一章
，Chapter 21，
就是新天新地。
It's new heavens and new earth.
是吗？这个就是彼得所盼望的新天新地。
This is what Peter was hoping and looking forward to.
新天新地，我们看见什么
？What do we see in this new heaven and new earth?
新妇好像新城耶路撒冷一样的从天上降下地上。
The bride is like the new city of Jerusalem is coming down from heaven.
这个。无可疑问的是神的教会。
There is no doubt about it. It's the church of God.
这是神的在永恒里面那个以色列国。
It is God's kingdom of Israel in eternity.
但是这个国呢是要一点点了解。
But we need to understand this kingdom.
这是二十一章里面二十二节。
Revelation 21 verse 22.
就一直讲下去，就讲到那个城呢是非常荣耀的。
It is talking about this very glorious city of God.
这个城里面有一个圣殿。
And in this city there is a temple.
是神和羔羊为城的殿。
It is where Lord God Almighty and the Lamb are the temple.
记住了，我们是那个城。
We are the city.
这个圣殿就是非常圣洁的地方是什么？神和羔羊。
This temple is very holy. It's a place with a God and the Lamb.
这个城也不需要灯的。
This city doesn't need light.
因为神的荣耀，基督就是这个城的光。
Because the glory of God, Jesus, is this light.
两处圣经讲到，列国都要把这个荣耀尊荣归给哪城
？And two places in the Bible talk about all nations have to give glory to this city.
所以你看见在永恒里面，城周围有列国。
in eternity, around the city, there are all the other nations.
所有的荣耀都集中在这个殿，这个城上。
All the glory comes upon this city.
二十七节里面谈到不洁的，就是不洁的，犯罪的不能够进城。
Verse 27, nothing impure will ever enter the city.
是不是有点奇怪？
Isn't it a bit strange?
新天新地。
New heaven and new earth.
新天新地啊。
New heaven and new earth.
都有不洁的吗？
Is there anything unpure?
你没有看见圣经说这个城的外边有些狗绿类跟这些行邪术的？
Have you read before that outside the city there are the dogs and also those who are do witchcraft?
你知道我讲什么？
You know what I'm talking about?
在新天新地的城外边还有一些不洁净的东西。
So in this new heaven and new earth outside the city there are still impure stuff.
因为什么？只有名字啊，总不能够进城，只有名字写在羔羊生命册上的才得进去。
So nothing impure can enter the city, only those whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life.
当我们受洗的时候，我们的名字写在生命册上。
When we were baptized, our names were written in this Book of Life.
启示录第三章第五节。
Revelation chapter 3, verse 5.
主对撒迪教会怎么讲？
The Lord spoke to the church of Sardis.
凡得胜的必将其穿白衣，我也必不从生命册上涂抹他的名。
The one who is victorious will, like them, be dressed in white. I will never blot out the name of that person from the book of life.
得胜的，你的名字就永远不会从生命册上被涂抹。
Those who are victorious, their name will never be blot out from the book of life.
证明了你的名字写在生命册上不一定是永远的。
That means that when your name is written on the book of life, it doesn't mean it's forever.
如果你是不冷不热的，
if you are not cold and not hot,
你是愚拙的童女，
if you're a foolish virgin,
你是口里面说主啊主啊，但是其实心里面没有真的尊主为大，
if your mouth speaks Lord, Lord, but in your heart you don't really honor the Lord,
你是不结果子的，
if you don't have good fruits,
这些基督徒他们的名字在生命册上是被涂抹的。
These Christians, their names will be blotted out of the
book of life. 因为他们没有得胜。
Because they haven't become
victorious. 得胜的就不会被涂抹。
Those who are victorious will not be blotted out.
只有名字在生命册上的才能够进到那个城。
Only those people whose name is on the book of life can enter the city.
进不了的就在门外哀哭切齿。
Those who cannot enter the city will be crying and in the gnashing of teeth outside the city.
所以哀哭切齿不是指到你下地狱。
So the gnashing of teeth is not pointing to those who will go to hell.
是指说你进不了城。
But about those who cannot enter the city.
其实如果你谈到预定论，
when you talk about predestination,
如果预定论是好像他们讲的那么真实，
if predestination is true,
写在生命册上就写下了，为什么还有机会被涂抹呢？
Then those names who are written in the book of life is written. Why is there a chance to be blotted out?
什么？所以我今天不谈这个预定论。
Let's not talk about the predestination.
但是你要了解这个城是谁能够进去。
But you need to understand who can get into the city.
然后启示录第三章第十二节。
Revelation the 3:12.
就得胜的，我要叫他在我城神殿中做柱子，他也必不再从哪里出去。
The one who is victorious, I will make a pillar in the temple of my God. Never again will they leave it.
这个是得胜的。
These are the people who are
victorious. 得胜的神要叫他做殿中的柱子，不是城中的柱子。
Those who are victorious, God wants them, ask them to be the pillars of the temple, not the pillars of the city.
现在考试了。
Okay, now we have a test.
神的殿在新天新地里面。
God's temple in this new heaven and new earth.
是什么？
What is it?
是在新城耶路撒冷城的里面。
It's inside the new city of Jerusalem.
所以得胜的。
So those who are victorious.
不单只能够做城里面进城。
Not only can they be enter into the city,
他能够成为神殿中的柱子。
They can become a pillar in God's temple.
所以你看见那个等级。
You can see the grades.
看见这个荣耀。
You can see the glory.
好了，所以呢，这个是启示录二十一章。
Revelation 21.
如果没有启示录二十章，就不会出现二十一。
Now, if there is no Revelation chapter 20, then you don't have chapter 21.
启示录二十章就是这个千禧年。
Revelation 20 is talking about the millennium.
换句话说，没有千禧年就没有新天新地。
In other words, without millennium, there is no new heavens and new earth.
新天新地之前一定是千禧年。
Before new heavens and new earth, there is the millennium.
现在我们就进到千禧年题目了。
Okay, so now we enter into the topic of millennium.
我不考试了，放过你们。
I will not have a test on you.
上一个礼拜我们谈到千禧年是什么？
What did we talk about millennium in the last week?
一开始的时候，个龙呢就被捆绑一千年。
So in the beginning, the dragon was bounded for 1,000 years.
我们与基督一同做王。
And we reign with Christ as King.
其实圣经里面说，还要一同做祭司。
We are also together as priests.
是做王做祭司。
We are priest and king together.
然后走到最后。
And finally,
就阿米吉哥顿的时候，又放那个龙出来。
The battle of Armageddon, that the dragon is re-released.
又围着蒙爱之城。
And it's around the city that God loves.
世界上人都知道这个是 end game， 是吧？世界上人都知道阿米吉哥顿。
Even the people of the world know this is the end game, the battle of Armageddon.
啊，怎么玩呢？
How does it end?
谁的唱炮最厉害呢？
Who has the strongest guns?
结局是什么样？主叫火从天上降临，就消灭他们。
God has his fire come down from heaven and just devour the enemies.
因为神呢不太喜欢用这个原子弹呢、核子弹呢。
Because God doesn't want to use bombs.
他干脆就用火来。
He just used fire.
并且他的火与我们的火不一样。
And his fire is different from our fire.
你知道，我们的火都要烧很久才会烧掉一些东西。
You know, even human fires need a lot of time to burn to complete the destroy
something. 天上降下来的火呢
？The fire from heaven
will wipe you out at no time. 就好像索多玛、俄摩拉，整个城就是归为乌有。
Just like in the days of Sodom and Gomorrah, the whole city will be wiped up in no time.
Like incineration,
disintegration,
yeah, 就是这个天上的火。所以呢，我们知道最后出来呢有一个敌基督。
And we know that in the end, there's an antichrist that come out.
上个礼拜我们讲到启示是一个的预言。
Last week we talked about a revelation is like a prophecy.
It's like a pattern. 有很多的成就。然后有个最后终极的成就。
And in this pattern of prophecy, the prophecies fulfill gradually in a process. And finally, the prophecy, there's a grand fulfillment.
所以会有敌基督、敌基督、敌基督，有最后的敌基督。
So there's Antichrist, 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 and in the end, there's a final Antichrist.
阿米吉哥顿就是讲到最后的敌基督。
And Armageddon is pointing at this final Antichrist.
他是怎么的死的？
So how did he die?
这个考试
testing you guys.
最后的敌基督是怎么死的？
How did the final Antichrist die?
答案
The answer
中奖的有100块钱
100 bucks for those who know.
我刚才差不多要讲100万
I almost said 1 million.
但是其实100万你们都不知道了。
But even if it's 1 million you don't know.
帖撒罗尼迦后书第二章第八节
2 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 8
保罗谈到那个敌基督。
Paul talked about this Antichrist.
那些些不法的人必显露出来，主耶稣要用口中的气灭绝他，用降临的荣光废掉他。
And then the lawless one will be revealed, whom the Lord Jesus will overthrow with the breath of his mouth and destroy by the splendor of his coming.
你看，千禧年，你看，千禧年龙被捆绑。
Can you see, in the millennium, the dragon is bound.
我们与基督一同做王做祭司。
We are king and priest with Christ.
最后龙要放出来。
And finally, the dragon is re-released.
敌基督大臣人之际显明。
And the Antichrist is revealed.
然后他们围着蒙爱之城。
And they surround the city that God loves.
主降临了。
And God comes upon them.
火从天上。
The fire comes from heaven.
他的荣光降临。
And his glory comes.
都一握手。
And
普通话怎么讲？
Cook them all and destroy them all. 一鑊熟，
呢個就叫一鑊熟。 有句好難聽嘅廣東話，不如我咁講。That's exactly what will happen. 然後就開始了新天新地。
Then starts the new heaven and the new earth.
有一件事情你要知道的。
One thing you must know.
那我現在加插一點東西。
I need to add some details.
如果以後有人問你呢，你能夠回答這些問題呢，你就是神學的博士。
If other people ask you in the future and you can answer, then you have a PhD in theology.
在以斯结书第四十章到四十八章。
In Ezekiel, from chapter 40 to 48,
谈到一个圣殿。
Talks about the temple.
这个圣殿与旧约这个圣殿的尺寸的不一样。
This temple differs from the Old Testament temple in the dimensions.
并且呢，那个祭祭的仪式也不完全一样。
And this whole priesthood, the
rituals
are different,
sacrifice.
And the sacrifices are different from those in the Old Testament.
所有的神学家都一致的证明着，这个以色列的以斯结的圣殿是在先禧年里面的圣殿。
All theologians agree that this temple referred in Ezekiel is the temple in millennium.
新天新地是不是有个圣殿呢？
Isn't there a temple in the new heavens and new earth?
以斯结里面。千禧年里面也有个圣殿。
In millennium, there is also a temple.
在千禧年里面，圣经讲得很清楚，我们是与主一同做这个祭司，一同做王。
So in millennium, it is clear that we reign with Christ as a king and priest.
又有祭司。
There is priesthood.
又有圣殿。
And there's a temple.
也有献祭。
And also prophets.
你想想，主耶稣是不是真体的在我们当中
？So do you think that at that time Jesus is with us
physically？ 这些献祭的影儿是指着基督。
These prophets are type and shadow pointing at Jesus.
The offering.
The offering.
Right. 如果主耶稣真体在
，If the physical presence of Jesus is with us, why would they need the sacrifices?
什么是祭司啊？
What is a priest?
这是神救赎的工程里面的一个工程。
It is in the is an important component in the whole salvation project.
In the grand process of redemption plan, 里面 redemptive plan 里面就有祭司是吗？所以在永恒里面需不需要祭司啊？
So in eternity, do we need priests?
只有君王。
We don't. We own. There's only kingship.
Yeah, 也不需要先知。
And there's no need for prophet.
但是有君王。
But there's king.
但是千禧年还是一个有祭司、有君王的时期。
But in millennium, there is still priesthood and kingship.
所以我们相信主耶稣是在千禧年的阿米吉哥敦那里的时候。Second coming of Christ, 第二次基督教降临是在那个时候。
We believe the second coming of Christ is actually at the Battle of Armageddon.
千禧年里面呢，一个最大的征战。
The biggest battle in the millennium.
因为那个时候已经没有巴比伦了。
Because at that time Babylon has already fallen.
没有兽了。
There's no more beast.
也没有这个龙了。
There's no dragon.
是吗？这样子应该没有问题了吗
？At that time, then there should be no problem.
还有一个问题。
But there is still one problem.
就是阿拉是神，或是耶和华是神
？Is that whether Allah is God or Yahweh is God？
到最后，以色列人要被钉围困的时候呢，他们要知道耶和华是神。
And in the end, when Israel's lights are being surrounded, they will know that Yahweh is God.
所以就有主降临，主降临。
And so that God's splendor come down.
好。啊，这样就你们现在已经是 expert。在千禧年与新天新地的 expert 了，现在你们分得开。
So now you guys should understand and differentiate between millennium and new heaven and new earth.
我没有讲之前，可能你们都分不清一些什么所谓的千禧年或者什么的什么新天新地。
Maybe before I explain, you were not able to differentiate what is the difference between millennium and new heaven and new earth.
这两点没有问题啊。
So are we clear on these two points?
十九二十三，OK，Yeah，好，现在就到十九章。
Okay, so we are in Revelation chapter 19.
就讲到羔羊的筵席。
It is about the Feast of the Lamb.
上一次呢，我们就讲得很清楚，原来不是吃哪个餐。
So last time we understand that this is not about what you eat in the feast.
因为是讲到吃所有人的驴肉。
Because we are eating other people's flesh.
这代表着国度的得胜。
It represents the victory of the kingdom.
开启这个千禧年的国度的。Kingship.
That starts this kingship in the millennium.
So, 有十九章，首先要经过十八章。
So, before we get to chapter 19, we are in chapter
18. 十八章讲到巴比伦的倒塌。
So, chapter 18 talks about the fall of Babylon.
巴比伦这个属兽的系统不倒塌。
If the beast system in Babylon doesn't fall,
这个十九章的基督的国度就很难被兴起得胜了，是吗？
Then it is hard for Christ's kingdom in chapter 19 to rise and be victorious.
就好像打仗。
It is like in a war.
如果有人赢
，If someone wins，
就有人输了。
Then someone would lose.
打球都是一样。
Same with a ball game.
如果有一个赢的
，If someone is winning，
就有一个输了。
Then someone else is losing.
赌钱都是一样。
Same with gambling.
有赢家就有输家。
There is the winning party and there is the losing party.
没有两个都是输家的。
You won't have two losers.
除非是打仗，就可能是两个都输。
Unless you're in a war, maybe both sides lose.
但是不可能两家都赢。
But it's impossible for both sides to win.
所以十八章是巴比伦的 crumbling.
So chapter 18 is about the crumbling of Babylon.
十九章是基督国度的胜。
Chapter 19 is about the rising of the Kingdom of God.
如果现在你懂得那么多，已经是差不多是一般个 expert 了。
So by now, if you understand all this, you are half an expert.
我要花一点时间谈到这个巴比伦的倒塌。
I need to talk about this fall of Babylon.
巴比伦倒塌之前会有什么
？What happens before the fall of Babylon?
启示录有什么
？Revelation. What happens?
有碗倒出来。
There's a pouring of the bowls.
也有一个时代的大复兴。
And there is also great harvest.
现在我们把我们的头脑里面的 Bible Gateway 这个圣经呢，翻到约珥书第一章。
So let's turn to Book of Joel, chapter 2, chapter 1.
你现在读圣经太难了。
It's too hard for you to find it.
你留心听我讲更好。
Just listen to me.
我这个讲义呢，已经发在那个群里面，你们可以拿到。
I have already shared this notes in the group.
约珥书第二章
，The chapter 2 of Book of Joel
讲了一段所有基督徒都懂的圣经。
It talks about something that all Christians know.
除非你不是灵恩派，可能你不懂。
Unless you are not charismatic, then maybe you don't know.
就是神要把他的灵浇灌凡有血气的。
That God will pour out His Spirit for all those with flesh.
信誉就会看一下。
Seeing you, like young people will see visions.
马弟兄就会发一下异梦。
Brother Ma, old people will dream dreams.
Yeah, Angela 跟 Nancy 就会仆人和侍女就发预言。
And servants and maids will prophesy.
非常出名的经文。
Very famous scriptures.
你们听得懂啊
？Do you understand?
这个在前几节就讲到是神祝福的春雨秋雨。
And before this, God talked about this is His blessing of the autumn rain and the spring rain.
这个春雨秋雨就是五旬节的两度的五旬节。
The autumn rain and the spring rain refer to the two times of Pentecost.
那个秋雨呢，就是第一次的五旬节。
The autumn rains refer to the first Pentecost.
然后现在谈那个春雨呢。就是这个 latter rain 就是末后的五旬节。
This spring rain is the latter rain, which is the second Pentecost.
为什么呢？因为谈到这个灵的浇灌。
Why is that? Because it's talking about the outpouring of the Spirit.
就谈到天上要显出奇事，有血，有火，有烟幕，日头变为黑暗，月亮要变为血。
It talks about a day of darkness and gloom, a day of clouds and blackness, and it turns into blood.
然后总括再一句话。这都是在耶和华大而可畏的日子未到以前。
And all this will happen before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord.
这个是代表什么？千禧年。
What is this representing? Millennium.
千禧年是耶和华报仇的日子。
Millennium is the day of the vengeance of the Lord.
千禧年不是新天新地，是耶和华大而可畏的日子。
Millennium is not the new heavens and new earth. Millennium is the great and dreadful day of the Lord. What happens before this great and dreadful day of the Lord? There's this great revival, great harvest.
现在懂了，回家要看懂这个约珥书一到二。
Now, please go home and read chapter 1 and 2 of Job.
然后前面第一章跟第二章一大半一直讲了什么？蝗虫啊。So
in Job, book of chapter 1, it talks about locusts.
这个蝗虫呢，是耶和华的军队。This
locust is the army of the Lord.
也讲到那个行走在耶和华里面的大军队是很有能力的。It's
talking about the powerful army of the Lord.
它是成就神旨意的蝗虫。
This locust, they fulfill the will of God.
但是他们来的时候是地暗天分，就是非常的destructive的，是一种的破坏的力量。When
they come, they are very destructive force.
所以他们绝对不是一个宗教或者属神的一个力量。So
obviously, they are not a religious or a Christian group of people.
是一个神所拣选。 用的一个的大能的力量。But
they are chosen and used by God as a mighty force.
因为他们来是毁灭性的。Because
their coming is destructive.
他们来是要推翻的。They
come to topple over.
所以你看见世界上面就有很多推翻性的力量。So
you can see in the world there's a lot of force to topple things over.
他们好像王室的蝗虫。They
are like locusts.
但这个力量 是耶和华的灵所感动。But
this force is actually moved by the Spirit of God.
他们来的时候呢，他们所拆毁的。When
they come, what they destroy.
在这个复兴的里面，神亲手说明，要把蝗虫所摧毁的，通通的保藏，再一次重建给你。So
God says that whatever they destroy in this revival time, God will make up for it.
好，看了，在哪里看？ 你把启示录跟约珥书连在一起看。So
now, if you look at Book of Revelation and the Book of Joel together,
蝗虫
locust,
然后时代大复兴
and the great harvest and revival.
蝗虫来
locust come,
毁灭推翻
to topple over and to destroy.
神的灵浇灌大复兴
and the outpouring of God's Spirit and great harvest revival.
启示录巴比伦倒塌
In Revelation, the Babylon falls.
一夜之间倒塌,
overnight.
巴比伦是怎么死的?
What is? How did Babylon die?
是他所骑的兽把他吞噬的.
It's the beast that the harlot rides on, eats, consumes the harlot.
这个兽的系统是什么?
What is this beast system?
是666.
It's 666.
这是一个 digital system, 一个 digital financial system, 是一个数据型的.
It refers to a digital financial system.
所以你可以骑着它很有能力,
so you can ride upon the beast and be very powerful.
但是要杀你也有易于反掌,
but to kill you, it's very easy.
所以杀你的时候呢, 很多在巴比伦外边的人都看着, wow, 那么有钱的巴比伦。
So when this system kills you, oh, those people who are outside will look, wow, this very prosperous Babylon. It fell in overnight.
就是没有人再买他的东西了。Nobody
buys their goods.
你明白吧? 最后这个巴比伦的系统一倒,
and finally, the Babylon system falls.
国度的兴起就时代的复兴开始。The
kingdom rises, and it's the great revival.
约珥书一到二
Book of Joel chapter 1 to 2
跟启示录18、19
and Revelation 18 and 19
是一个很好像明显的对照，好像镜子对照。
It is like a mirror reflecting upon each other.
好了
Okay
17章开始的很简单的
Revelation 17
小孩子都懂了。
It's very simple.
17章就讲到这个 就也讲到这个大淫妇。
It talks about the harlot.
16章、15章就讲到七个碗。
Revelation 16 and 15 talks about the seven bowls.
也谈到这个，14章就谈到这个神的那个144,000。
Revelation 14 talks about God's 144,000.
这个也是谈到新城耶路撒冷。
And the new city of Jerusalem.
因为新城耶路撒冷的 就是14,000 cubic 的。因为长或高都是12,000的。
Because the dimensions of New City of Jerusalem adds up to 144,000.
所以14章好像一个简介。
So the Revelation 14 is
like an index.
Right,
谈到这个羔羊的七十四万四千。
It talks about the 144,000.
谈到这个大人妇。
The harlot.
谈到这个兽。
The beast.
他们两者都要一同被审判。
Both the harlot and the beast will be judged.
然后谈到一个时代的大复兴。
And then the great harvest, the great revival.
十三章就谈到有两个兽的灵。
Revelation 13 about the spirit of the two beasts.
最后他们成了一个系统。
And they become a system.
这个系统就是数据的经济型的系统。
The digital finance system.
有十二章就是男孩子。
And Revelation 12 is about man-child.
如果你相信男孩子，
If you believe in the man-child,
在2017年9月23号出现，
was birthed in September 23rd, 2017.
也知道哪一天也同样是新约到2000年的尽头。
And also know that it is the end of the 2,000 years of New Testament.
因为它是120个的吹角节。
Because there are, it is the 120th Feast of Trumpet.
50年一次的吹角。
And every 50 years there is this feast.
刚好的2017年9月20日，男孩子出生哪一天呢？那个新生的哪一天是新月的2000年？
So just right is the birth of the man-child, September 2017 is the 2,000 years of the New Testament.
也是人类的6000年。
It is also the 6,000 years of humanity.
所以就来到圣经里面说，彼得说的，神看千年如日日，一日又如千年。
So it comes to where Peter said, God sees 1,000 years as a day, and a day as 1,000 years.
所以从这个文法来说，哪一天其实应该是一个第七千年的，就是 millennium 的开始。
So reading from this it,
theologically,
then this is the 7,000 years beginning is the beginning of the seventh day.
现在是不是很头很乱啊？
Is it very confusing?
Okay. 也没有时间讲后面。我想。如果你们不太乱呢，我就加插一点非常精彩的东西给你。
If you are not too confused, I'll add some interesting supplements.
不然的话呢，就可以真的知道，现在是我们走到这个新月跟这个先几年中间这个转型啊 transitional period 的尾声。
We are right now in the transitional period from New Testament to the millennium.
要巴比伦就快要倒塌。
And Babylon is about to fall.
Okay, 看你们好像还有五分钟的精神。
It looks like you still have 5 minutes of attention span.
我讲得很快。
Okay, I'll talk about this quickly.
如果你们喜欢呢，你们可以查考这个 Dr. Irvin Baxter.
If you like, you can go on the web and search about Dr. Irvin Baxter.
他有很多的研究写到那个七号。
He has a lot of writing studying about the seven trumpets.
开始的时候呢，他就是留意着这个第三号。
So to start with, he focused on the third trumpet.
就是启示录里面呢，就有一个星叫做阴沉，掉在海里面死了。死了很多人。
So in Revelation, there is a star called Wormwood, and it falls onto the sea, and a lot of people die.
这个是第三号。
This is the third trumpet.
这个阴沉呢，在苏联里面呢，苏联里面那个字呢，叫做Chernobyl.
The Russian word for Wormwood is Chernobyl.
你们读历史就会知道了。
So we all know in history what Chernobyl is.
Chernobyl 就是 Russia 这个苏联里面的叫做。
In Russian language, this Chernobyl means wormwood.
所以就是一个的他们那个的核子的研究的 project 项目。
It is the nuclear project.
Yeah, 然后有两次的失败爆发。
And then there were two failures causing explosions.
所有的瑕疵的毒就流到那个河流里面。
All these toxins were released into the river.
就死了 125,000人。
And 125,000 people died.
有200万人呢, 就得到了癌症。
And 2 million people got cancer.
真的是跟那个, 第三号很吻合, huh?
Which matches very well with the third trumpet.
第二号呢就是世界第二次大战。
And the second trumpet was World War II.
因为我知道从圣经里面讲到 有死了很多人，就是特别是三分之一的船被打坏了。So
in the Bible says a lot of people died, and in particular, a third of the ships were destroyed.
所以在第二次大战里面呢，有105,127艘船是有几样级的船。So
in World War II, there were 105,127 ships.
有32,000艘船是打沉的。
And among these, 32,000 were sunk,
就刚好是三分之一,
which is a third of the ships.
所以他讲的很有道理的,
so it seems very logical.
然后, 世界第一次大战就是第一号,
and the first trumpet, it was the World War I.
然后第六号,
and the sixth trumpet,
就讲到巴拉大河里面有四个狮子放出来杀很多人,
It talks about there are four angels who are released in the great river of Euphrates and kill a lot of people.
那个就是我们的 ISIS的发源地。
That is the origin of ISIS.
所以我们知道现在 ISIS都差不多没有了。
And we know that ISIS now has almost been exterminated.
但前几年呢，前十几年， 那个ISIS的力量其实就是第六号。
But a few years ago, the power of ISIS actually is a sixth trumpet.
很凶残的一个势力出来杀很多人,
A very cruel power that comes and kill a lot of people.
结尾呢，我要谈第五号。
And so we now talk about the fifth trumpet.
是很精彩。
It's very exciting.
你们还记得1991年那个时候那个猴差任那个跟 跟我们之间的问题哦, Iraq,
and you know, in 1991, Saddam Hussein, we are all familiar with what happened.
圣经的第五号就是讲到有蝗虫从这个谷底抗出来。
So in the Bible, the fifth trumpet talks about there are locusts coming out from this great abyss.
天昏地暗,
and the sky gets darkened.
刚好在1991年呢,
and in 1991,
在 Kuwait 里面有700个油田呢,
In Kuwait, there are over 700 oil fields that were burnt on fire.
然后呢, 2个月的时候看不见太阳。
And for 2 months, the smoke blocked the sun and blackened the sky.
你们那个时候还是不是大人了, 已经看见那个,
were you guys adults and can read the news?
700个油田焚烧, 地分天红。
So 700 oil fields were burnt and the whole sky was darkened.
圣经里面讲到的蝗虫是身体的盔甲。
And in Bible, they talk about this locust has a armor,
男人的脸,
and a face of a human,
就是人坐在飞机上面,
and that's when a person sits in the plane,
他们翅膀的声音好像许多战车马兵的声音,
and the noise of these wings is like a lot of horses and chariots.
约翰在2000年前看的时候，其实是飞机。
Actually, when John saw in the vision 2,000 years ago, he was looking at airplanes.
但可能他看得很小。
Maybe he just small, very small.
大堆蝗虫出来。
And there are locusts coming out.
地分天暗。
And the whole sky is darkened.
然后有很奇妙的，这是有一个的王做蝗虫的领袖。
And that there is a king which is the leader of the locusts.
名字叫做亚波伦。
And the name is Apollyon.
就是希伯来文，就是说。 那个 destroyer 这个毁灭者
and in Hebrew it means the destroyer
刚好那个时候
and just at that time
侯差人就强奸了他的母亲
Saddam Hussein raped his mother
然后呢 医生本来要把这个孩子堕胎
and the doctor was originally going to abort this child
但是这个母亲呢 就坚决的偷偷的就把孩子生出来
but the mother insists on giving birth to this child
就叫这个孩子叫做亚伯伦
And named the child Apollyon.
就是翻出来意思就是 destroyer, 就是毁灭者。
Which means destroyer.
那你把这个跟蝗虫连在一起，你就知道，母亲说， 侯差人把我跟他的国家都已经毁灭了。
If you connect this with the locust, then you understand that when the mom says he calls this child Apollyon because he's the destroyer.
不是 Apollyon, 亚波伦, 不是 Napoleon, 亚波伦.
Apollyon. Yeah, then saying that he is the destroyer of Iraq and her.
所以我们知道最后 Iraq 就是在侯差人的手中毁了。
And we know in the end that Iraq was destroyed by the hands of Saddam Hussein.
也带给他那个地方很多的痛苦。
And brought a lot of pain to that country.
所以呢，你有机会你就回去看看这个 Dr. Irving Baxter 的书。
So you can go online and check out Dr. Irving Baxter.
世界上面有很多关于启示录的书。
In the world, there are a lot of books about Revelation.
有很多的书呢。都真真假假假假，有些对的地方，有些错的地方。
A lot of books have aspects that are right and the aspects that are wrong.
但是很有智慧的人
，But wise person，
真的爱神的话语的人
，Those who really love the word of God，
不会因为有很多错误的东西，你就不会寻求这真实的东西。
Will not stop searching for the truth just because there's a lot of fake things outside.
在有很多错误的预言里面
，even among the wrong prophecies，
错误的解释里面
，or wrong interpretations，
那真实的解释与真实的预言是非常的难能可贵的。
The truth, the true prophecy and the true interpretation is very precious.
就是因为有那么多错误对启示录的解释
，and it's exactly because there are so many wrong interpretations.
你都昏了头，都不知道听哪个好，所以干脆就不听。
Some people just feel so dizzied by it that you just forget about it.
Seriously, right? Seriously, 有上千个解释。
There are thousands of interpretations.
关于启示录。
About the book of Revelation.
但是如果你真的爱神的话语
，But if you love the word of God.
我们就会寻求神真实的预言。
We will seek and find out the truthful meaning of God's prophecy.
你每天都可以跟主说
，You can ask God every day.
求你把启示录的那个奥秘向我们解开。
Please reveal to us the book of Revelation.
因为我们是行在光中白昼的。
Because we walk in the day and the light.
我们不是行在黑夜里面不知道神的心的人。
We are not those who walk in darkness or in night, those who do not understand the word of God.
好不好？花一点时间，这两篇的信息，如果你听不明白，就听多几天，或者在纸上写。我也有这个讲义，上次的根子基督，可以你们可以拿到。
So please go back and study, and I also have notes for you for last time and this time.
是中英文的 notes.
It's bilingual.
Yeah. 所以这样子呢，你们把这两篇的事实了解呢，你就是已经多多少少了解启示录的个方向。
So if you understand these two sermons, you pretty much understand the direction of the book of Revelation.
Hallelujah.我相信神为我们预备的已经是非常的丰足。
I believe what God has prepared for us is very, very.
包括这个帖杖的财富
，including the scepter wealth，
也走不了我们的份。
We will have a part in it.
虽然我们现在这个钱没有流通，能够用。
Even though the money hasn't become liquid for usage,
但是已经为我们存留。
But it is already prepared.
并且我们的朋友已经站在很高的经济的位置。
And our friend is standing on a very important position.
所以我们的前途非常光明。
And we have a good future ahead of us.
但在这个重要的关头。
But in this important critical time,
我们要透过我们祷告的能力。
We need to use our power of prayer,
祝福的能力,
power of blessing,
审判的能力,
power of judgment,
为祈求神一个受的系统的倒塌,
and seek God for this fall of the system of the beast,
Babylon 的倒塌,
the crumbling of Babylon,
神国度里面君王体系的兴起,
the rise of this kingship,
我们在这里等待黎明。
And we await here for the dawn.
是的，好像边云波所讲。
Just like Brother 边云波 said.
当人间越发到他的慈，那个桥很幽暗，刺客。
When humanity walks into a very dark and deep and difficult times,
世界各地有些地方是在动乱之中。
And in the world, there are many places that are in chaos.
黎明的曙光是遥遥可见。
We can see the light of dawn from afar.
几十年前他说是遥遥可见。
Many years ago, he said that we see it from afar.
今天我们可以说就在眼前。
Today we can see it's right before our eyes.
我是非常荣幸的跟你们一同。
I'm very honored to be walking with you.
能够一同的见证这个历史性的时刻就在我们的眼前。
That we can witness this historical moment right before our eyes.
所以我们要在我们的路上，我们的使命上面站稳了。
So we must stand steady in our path.
因为圣经说巴比伦倒塌。
Because the Bible says Babylon is fallen.
神国度得胜了。
God's kingdom is victorious.
龙被铁链捆住了。
And the dragon is bound in chains.
千禧年即将开幕。
And the millennium is about to begin.
让我们低头祷告。
Let's pray.
亲爱的主耶稣，祝福我们每一位。
Bless each of us.
叫我们听的人能够听得明白。
Let us who hear, we can understand.
我们听明白了，又能够遵守。
And that when we understand, we can keep your word.
这一本最难读的书《启示录》，我们都能够明白又遵守。
And that this most difficult book of Revelation, we can understand and keep.
我们就有福了。
And we will be blessed.
祝福这一位。
We bless everyone here.
祷告是奉主耶稣基督的名求。
We pray in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.